Hello, everybody. Hey, hi everybody. So we're doing some watercolor veggies today. We're going to do them in the loose style, and just to make this a little bit fun, I actually have the veggies with me today. So let's keep them in front of us and paint them. Yes, it's going to be fun. So we're going to paint things like lemon and tomatoes that you find in your kitchen. And we're going to paint it in a loose style, which means that we're not going to use too many layers. So even if you don't have a fancy watercolor paper, it's fine, because we're not going to apply too many layers. It's going to be just one layer or two layers. And we're going to do it in a very loose style. So please get your watercolors with you in the meanwhile. We'll wait for another 5 minutes for everybody to join. So I have this really old palette from Camel. I think I have it since a very long time. So I'm going to use this. And let's take a nice 5 or 6 number brush. So I think I'm going to take a 5-number brush. I have one from Princeton. If you don't have this, a local brush will also do. I also use these a lot. So anything that you can arrange, a bigger size, maybe a 5 or a 6. Hello, everybody. Okay. So I think we should start with the carrot, okay? And they're kind of, just going to try it first, yeah. So I'm just going to keep it here so that it's easier for us to see and do it. Okay, and I'm sitting very close to my window today, so we can see where the shadow is falling. So when you're doing loose watercolor, you know, it's very important that you do not try and add every small detail that you can see. Just hold the object, see around. So you see these ridges, you see this kind of a root that carrot has. Okay, so I'm going to just look at it for some time so that I get an idea as to how it looks, and then we're going to start painting it. So the one that I have over here is like the Angrezi gajar or the English carrot that I have. So I'm going to take a lot of orange for this. Remember, don't use your colors too watery this time. Take a lot of pigment. So I'm going to just switch off the commons for some time. Okay. So I'm going to take some good orange. And let's be as loose, as freestyle as we can be. So we'll start with orange, and I'm going to keep this as a reference here and try and leave some white space also. Okay, and I'm just going to drip my water. Sorry, remove my water. And okay, so that's how my carrot looks. Now I'm going to take some red. Sorry for my palette, it is it's already dried up. And I'm going to add, if I look at the carrot, I find that there is a little bit of dark areas here. So I'm just going to, while the color is still wet, I'm going to leave it there. A little bit over here and at the bottom. Maybe some ridges that I can see, these lines. Like I said, it's loose watercolors, so just ensure that there are no hard edges and just have fun. Do not try to overdo it, which I think is the most difficult thing for me. You know, I sometimes overdo it so much that I spoil it. So don't do that mistake. So we have one carrot here. Okay, and if you want to give it a little more darkness at one of the edges, so you can by mixing a little bit of maroon and red. And okay, now what I'm going to do is quickly take some nice fresh green here. Okay, and although this one doesn't have those leaves, but I want to draw some nice leaves to the carrot, and I think I should have left more space, which I didn't. But so okay, it's going to be very rough. Like I said, we are not trying to create the exact shape. It should look like a carrot. We are trying to ensure that it looks like a carrot. So I'm going to do it in two styles. One is this style where I'm going to do it like this, and the other one is where I'm going to ink it with a black pen later. So let's do it one more time in case you missed it the first time. So we are going to again draw the carrot. So if you are planning to make this as a complete thing, this is not. This is more like a study of you know, vegetables that we are doing today. So again, if you don't have a carrot at home, just look at the picture that I'm holding with my hand right now, and you can use that as a reference. Also, your carrot doesn't have, so if you see, I am not using the exact color. My point today is not to use the exact color. It's just to have fun. This is a very good exercise to do, to understand how different things have different shapes, what kind of you know, designs do they have. And the more you practice, the more you'll get better at it. So I like the second carrot that I've done more than the first one. And while this is still wet, while your red is still wet, use the green so that it kind of little bleeds into the orange. Okay. And I'm going to leave it now. Okay, don't forget to draw these little ridges in red. So what you can do is just take a little bit of red and draw these little ridges, these lines that you can see. And I'm going to wait for now a few minutes for all of you to finish till here, then we'll move on to the next vegetable. A little bit of white here and there adds that freshness to the carrot. So leave that little white. Ashna, you're asking how many are we going to paint? I don't know, let's see how many we can finish in an hour's time. You can let me know on the chat box if you wish to continue ahead, if I should go ahead. Yes, even I like the second one more. And what I'm going to do is, like I told you, I'm going to do it in two different styles. So I let the first one be as it is, maybe the second one as it is, and the first one I'm just going to ink it with a pen. So I am using a micron pen here, and I'm just going to lightly ink it here. Not everywhere, I'm just lightly going to, and I don't even have to follow the shape. ओके सो आई एम जस्ट लाइटली इंकिंग इट एंड आई थिंक आई शुड लेट इट ड्राई अदरवाइज आई स्पॉइल इट सो लेट लेट इट ड्राई लेट मी नॉट हरी दिस अप विच बुक आर यू यूजिंग आई एम यूजिंग दिस बुक by scholar I guess yeah this is a scholar store watercolor A5 book that I'm using okay now let's move ahead and let's try and draw a tomato okay so I'm going to keep the tomato over here. I want to draw it. So this is like an Indian tomato. The ones that you find outside India are much more pulpier and they're more round. So I think I'm going to draw that shape. Somehow that looks like a tomato more to me. So let's start with a nice red color first. Like I told you, leave that little white here and there. So let's start with the tomato and for that we are going to draw a C shape, okay? So I'm going to draw the C shape and I'm going to take some red plus yellow. Okay, and I think my yellow is not that great. That's how I have drawn my I'm going to take some red plus blue you have to really move fast with watercolors because okay, I think this is too dark I didn't intend to make it that dark but it's okay I'm going to pick up some white okay so I've just lifted some ink from the paper and this is how I think my tomato is going to look now so I'll let it dry for some time and then we'll work on it so let me show you another way of doing the same tomato I'm sorry if I'm hurrying up but since we're doing loose watercolor florals it's very important that when your color is wet that time you apply your next color because you don't want hard edges so let's do it one more time and let's use the red color and again I'm going to use some red plus orange some plain yellow now Just going to lift some color from here. Now this one I'm going to use some red plus a good blue here. I want a nice purple shade, which I couldn't get the first time. So I think. So I'm going to switch to a different palette and I'm going to pick up my purple. If you don't have it, red plus blue should give you a nice purple shade. But unfortunately. My colors are very very dry so I'm going to take some purple shade here from a different palette and just apply a little okay now Honestly, this tomato of mine looks a little bit flat, but that's okay. This is acrylic paint. No, dear, I'm using watercolor paints. These are watercolors that I'm using today. So this is the one that I'm using. Actually, I have this from, I think, when I was in 10th standard. So I remember when I gave my elementary intermediate exams is when I bought this palette and I've not used it and the lockdown has given me enough opportunity now to start using it again So this is a really old palette. But I wanted to use this palette and not an expensive one, because I wanted to show you that even camel paints are very good to use. So what I'm going to do now is, it's kind of dry, so I'm just going to draw the cap of my tomato. Okay, so that's the cap of my tomato here. Usually this one doesn't have it, but if you see those pulpy ones, I love those tomatoes which have that red cap on it, the green cap on it. And for the other one, for this one, this tomato, I'm going to do it in a different style. So what I'm going to do is, I'm just going to let it bleed. So this is how I'm going to do this tomato. Like I'm saying, it's a loose style, okay? So enjoy it and don't fret over not getting it right the first time. Try it multiple times, I'm sure you will get your tomato right. So I think this one is a little dry now, this carrot here. So I'm going to start inking it. Like I told you, I'm going to do this in an ink way. Okay, so you can be extremely rough and do this. Like you see, I'm not trying to I'm going to keep my hand loose and not worry too much about coloring within the lines. Okay, and these lines that I'm talking about is what I'm trying to achieve here. So I'm just going to do some lines here. Okay, and here I'm just going to, so I'm just using a very light scribble method. And you don't have to outline everything, just something so that it looks like a carrot. If you're wondering where you can use this, you can use this if you want to do some recipe illustration. If you like, if you want to ever come out with your own recipe book, you can make such illustrations, and it's quite helpful. You can make patterns out of it. So yes, that's my carrot. So I've done it in two different styles. Let's move on to this one. Again, this is a little wet right now, so I'm going to leave it as it is. What you can do is, in this one, let me show you something else also. So I'm going to take some blue color here. Again, a lot of blue color. And this is a different way altogether. So if you see, all the four are very different styles. I'm going to take enough water. So I've taken blue color and a lot of water. Okay, and now I'm going to just tap over here. So what I've tried to do is, once we ink it, you will understand, but I have wanted to create a little bit of splash effect there. So that's another way of doing it. I'm just going to let it be. Okay, in the meanwhile, while this is drying up, let's try and do a lemon. Okay, so we need nice yellow color for this. So I think you need a nice lemon yellow shade for this. So I'll start with a nice lemon yellow shade. Okay, and if you see a lemon closely, it is a little pointed over here. You know, when you keep it, you'll find that it has a little bit of a pointed tip here. So let's not make it a perfect circle, but more like an oval. Also, it doesn't have a lot of orange, but to make it visually interesting, I am going to add a little bit of orange to this. So just a little bit of nice orange. A little bit of green too. Okay. I didn't pause the live, Deepika. I think my Wi-Fi just went off, so I've switched to my mobile data. I don't know if for how long was it paused. I hope you guys got it. Okay, so I think I've spoiled this one for sure. So you can ignore this. Okay. And let's try doing one more tomato. Let's try doing one more of this. So what I'm going to do is draw a nice ball with red paint. Adding some key. It's not clear. I'm sorry guys, I think there's some issue with my net today. Can you just show me a thumbs up if it's clear now? Absolutely clear. Thank you so much, Disha Didi. Okay, and if you must have noticed, I had kind of spoiled your, and there is no shame in accepting that you as an individual can spoil things. So learn from your mistakes, and I never like when I spoil things. I get very, very frustrated. So what I did is I just used some red color and I just kind of made the outline again, and I think these platters look good. I like this kind of a style also. So there are different styles, is what I'm trying to tell you. This one is like loose watercolor, this one is more with, you know, inking it after the watercolors, this one is with a little bit of splatter. With the lemon now, I'm going to draw some big leaves for the lemon. Okay, so let's take nice fresh green. Okay, and I'm going to draw some nice leaves for the lemon, and my leaves are ready. Try and get those leaves in just one or two strokes. If you overdo it, that means you've spoiled it. Leave it. For this tomato over here, again, I'm going to draw like a little cap here, and I'll let it smudge a little. Can we do the lemon again? Yes, we can. Let's do the lemon again. So we'll do the lemon again. We'll take the nice lemon yellow color. So I'm not using this palette because you can see my yellow color is gone. So I have another palette from where I'm going to use my nice lemon yellow color. And so like I told you, if you look at it closely, the lemon has a little, it's kind of tapered towards the bottom. So I'm going to get that shape while I'm doing it the first time. Okay, I'm going to take some nice, rich yellow color and just leave it at some places. Take a little bit of orange. Again, don't overdo it, otherwise your lemon will look like an orange. So just some places. Always clean your brush when you move on to the next color. If you forget to leave the white highlight, just take your brush and pull out the color. When you pull out the color will just come out. So don't worry if you're not able to leave any white. Now I'm going to take some green color and add it at some places, only towards the edges, to kind of give that little roundness to my lemon. Okay. And it shouldn't look like you've outlined the lemon, so try and move the color inside. And since I'm using something which is like a textured paper, I already like the texture that's kind of coming through. Now when this is still wet, I'm going to draw the leaves. I have just started reading the comments, so I'm sorry if I missed out on something. If there's anything that I missed out, you can again let me know. So I also had a piece of pumpkin here and I thought we'll also do the pumpkin. It's just out of the refrigerator. So if you guys are done with this, maybe we can move on to the next fruit. I think we should also do a brinjal. Need some color here, so we can do the brinjal too. Okay. So I'm planning to do something really fun today. It's just 5:30. If anybody wants to show me their work, so what you can do is just send me a request to be in my live video, and I will accept it, and maybe we can have a small quick chat and you can show me what you have done till now. So anyone who wants to be in the live video and show me, and if they're painting along with me, I'll be happy to have you on board. So just send me a request and let's see your work. okay, now this one I'm going to again ink it, okay? So I'm going to hold my pen not straight, but I'm going to hold it at in this way, fashion, and I'm just going to draw thick lines here, okay? So this is a different way of inking it. I'm just drawing it in a very rough way, if you see this. Here, if you want, you can even add a little bit of a shadow. So this is a different style of making your tomato. You can actually make a pattern just with some tomatoes and maybe some lemon, a red and yellow combination. Doesn't it spoil the pen? Yes, if the pen is, if the paint is wet and you use the pen, it will spoil the pen. So if you are patient, please let it dry and then use your pen. And if you're impatient like me, then you will keep spoiling pens like I do, because I'm just so in a hurry. But have patience and then do the outline. Yes, it will be saved on my YouTube channel. Let's move on to our brinjal now. Okay. So let's go and do a brinjal. For that, I need some purple shade. So I'm going to take some purple color. And I'm going to use this paper in the best fashion. So I'm just going to tilt it, and now I'm going to draw my brinjal here. It's called an eggplant or brinjal, whatever. Okay, so I've taken enough purple, and let's begin. So I've left a little white highlight below because I want to show a little bit of that white. Just going to take some yellow and fill it here. Now if you see this, I'm doing this in a very different way than I usually have done my other veggies. I'm going to use colors like yellow. I've mixed some red with my purple, and just here at the edge I'm adding a little darker shade of the color. Let's do the brinjal again. Not quite happy with the first one. I think I can do a better job. Yes. I think this one is way, way better than this one. I think the green here has to be a little more brighter. You can keep adding in this whole page. You can keep adding a lot of veggies and fruits, and your practice can also become like something which is nice. Just going to add some water scribbles here. So I showed you two different ways of inking it. So this one was like the plain lines. We are not really following where the color is. This one was more like a scratchy kind of, you know, style. Let's try and outline this lemon here now. So I've outlined the lemon too, and like you can see, this one is again a little scribbly effect that I've tried to give here. Or you can just give these water droplets kind of an effect. Just remember that when you're coloring it, watercoloring it loose, it's very important that you know, you use just two or three shades and try to get that try to get the vegetable look realistic. So for example, over here I've added a lot of orange, and in my tomato you wouldn't find a lot of orange, but just to make it visually appealing and it to, you know, kind of make it stand out, I've used more orange to give the highlights. Now I have this brush pen. Can you tell me how did you make that purple color? I have used it directly from my palette. I did not make the color, but if you want to make the color, you can mix red and blue and you should get a nice purple shade. I will upload on YouTube, no issues. Okay, so this is a brush pen that I have from Micron. Okay. And again with the brush pen, I'll show you how I'm going to outline this with just strokes. So that's another way of illustrating. So you will get bolder strokes and you can add your depth and you can add a shape to your vegetable. hot pressed or cold pressed paper. Just a second. I think it is. It's cold pressed. I'm using cold pressed paper here. Now, if you want to make this only like a pattern, and what you can do is just draw some leaves here and there, and this could be a nice pattern that you would have created for yourself. So, like I'm going to do, I'm just going to draw some leaves. And this would be a nice this whole thing will come together. So you can just draw lemons all over your page and just draw some leaves here and there, and that would be a beautiful pattern that you can use. Madhuji, I'm not saving it on IGTV. I will be putting it up on my YouTube channel so that it stays there forever and you can go and refer to it. Okay, so there's Disha who wants to be in the live video. Let me show me something. I'll be happy to have you live and show me what you have done. Yes, both the drawings are almost same. Hi, Dish.
Hi, Vibha.
So, what have you done?
I'll just show you.
Yes. Whoa, wow. Did you have fun doing this?
Yeah, it was amazing.
You've done it so beautifully. I love the way you've done your tomatoes.
Thank you.
It's come out very nice. I can see the light, shadow everywhere.
Thank you. I really always attend your live sessions because you explain it very nicely.
Thank you so much, Disha. That feels good to hear that you're actually learning and it's kind of making an impact somewhere at least. Thank you so much for your kind words.
Thank you.
Thank you, dear. So we had Disha with us who came live and showed us her drawings. If there's anybody else who wants to show me what they have done, please go ahead and I'll just send me a request to be in the live and I'll add you. Can you blend some leaves together? Madhuji, I do not understand what are you trying to imply. Do you want me to show you how to blend leaves? Okay, I think if there is nobody else, we can end the session. And if you've missed the session, you can always catch it on my YouTube channel. Do let me know in the comments there if you happen to go there and see the video. Please let me know if you like the video and what more would you like to learn. Okay, so you want to see the blending of leaves. Honestly, when you're doing loose watercolor florals, loose watercolors, you don't really have to do a lot of blending. You just have to move your brush in a way that it forms a leaf shape. So if you want to still see it, I can show it to you. So it's the way you move your brush, honestly, it's not really the blending. So how you create the thin and thick strokes. So this is how you can make leaves. I'm just using the leftover paint from my palette and I'm showing you different kinds of leaves that you can make. Like I said, it's all about how you use your brush, how you create those thick and thin strokes. Yes, you can overlap if you're making a basket. You can do that. So whenever I do my live sessions, I try to give you the first step, like, you know, and I give you a lot of ideas that you can go and explore. The point here is so that you understand how to capture light and shade and, you know, shadows. And then you can use it in your own style. You can make a basket or you can draw other fruits and veggies. If you want me to do this live session the next time also, like if you want me to continue with some more vegetables, I'll be happy to do that. Just let me know after the session on DM, and if I have a lot of people who want it, I'll do some more fruits and veggies the next Friday we meet. Thank you, Harun. Thank you for that comment. Some good brushes for watercolors and acrylics. For watercolor, I cannot really suggest you some good brushes. I can tell you what I've used and what I like. So I like Princeton. I use this a lot, and I showed this local brand that I use, which is I think Ujala and Aurora. These are available in any local stationery. I've used them all my life, right from elementary intermediate exams to my graduation. It's only now that I've switched to these better brand. I can't really call them better brand, but yeah, the more expensive brands. Okay, thank you so much everybody for joining. I think I'm going to end the session now. I'll see you next Friday. Bye. Stay happy and stay safe, guys. Bye. Okay, I please let me know on either in the YouTube comments, or you can let me know via DM, or you can let me know on Instagram on any of my posts, and I'll make a note of this. Maybe we can do some more fruits and veggies the next time too. Thank you so much, Disha Didi. Thank you so much, Shruti Didi. Thank you, Aarti. Thank you, Madhuji. Thank you, Gopika. Bye.